Flo asks, if I have Google Workplace Starter Pack, I assume that is the individual version or the business starter edition. Will my main Gmail addresses be also my admin email address, or do I need to create another email account, or should I create another email account and pay $8 for my admin? Yeah, I think what Flo is asking here is you've just set up a Workspace account and you need to have one account as an administrator. Is that going to cause you to need to create an extra paid user for your admin account? And I think I'm going to go ahead and draw this one out. So let's move along to my handy little Jamboard here, and let's see how good my drawing skills are here. So let's draw a little man here, and let's draw a little another. Well, let's call them persons, not men, because you know it's 2022, and we're gender neutral here. Okay, cool. So we have two little people here, and what this person is asking is, okay, is it when someone becomes a new subscriber to Google Workspace, do I have to actually pay an extra admin account? So administrator access inside of Google Workspace is role-based. And what that means is you don't have to have a individual defined administrator. It's just a role. And so what that means is effectively you are just putting on the hat of an administrator, and any one of your users can put on the administrator hat. So that means you do not have to pay for an extra license for the administrator, and the individual person who is designated as an administrator can be any of the users inside your company. Now, what does that actually look like when you do that to designate somebody as an administrator? Well, the first thing that you want to do is you want to head along to your Google admin console. And so you go to admin.google.com, and that's going to load up your admin console. You need to be the administrator to do this, and so you need to log in with the first user that you created inside your Workspace account. But then once you have the different users listed in your account, we can actually add the hat of an administrator to that account. So let me go ahead and open up someone, Aldrin here. We have who I'm going to don him as an administrator. You can see here that once I have his account open, I can see all of the different options available to manage this person's individual account. And one of those options is admin roles and privileges. And so I want to assign a role or help him to put the hat on. And you can see here, if I wish, I can switch on the super administrator account. And that's going to, once I hit save, give him that hat. Now, it's important that you be very considerate about who you give administrator access to your business and to your Workspace account. Many people, when they start, they think, oh, well, you know what? I'd like my assistant to help me out adding users. And so let me just give them super admin so they can access everything. Now, what you'll find is many business owners and entrepreneurs forget about that and then get years down the line, but somebody else in your company still has access to your account. Or even worse, if you have set up your Workspace account yourself and you're a little bit lax on the security settings, you may even have someone leave the company, you may forget to change their password or consolidate their account properly, and you may actually have an administrator floating around there where other people may be able to actually get access to that by guessing that person's password or by accessing the account through other, you know, kind of hacking and phishing means. So I'd be very careful about who you designate administrator access to. Really only give super administrator access to someone else who is a shareholder or a director of the business. It's not really appropriate to share that with anyone else unless you're large enough that you have dedicated senior technology staff inside the business. But remember that you also have lots of other options in administrator rights that you can grant to your team. And so some of the other roles that are available, for example, instead of using super admin, might be to just designate someone as a user manager. So that would be really useful for someone like your HR or your people manager who needs to onboard and offboard staff technically. They can change passwords, they can add and remove people, and they can change very basic user settings, but they're not able to, for example, change your company-wide logo inside your Workspace account and change that for everyone. Or, you know, administrator a Google Chrome policy that would change the background of everybody's computers inside the account. Okay, what other options do we have here? We have a groups admin. So this would be someone who would be appropriate to manage groups within the business. Again, that might be someone who is, you know, like an HR or a people manager. That might make sense for them to be able to do that. Next, you've got a services admin or a help desk admin. Those people have access to not add and remove users, but they do have access to reset people's passwords. So that would make sense for someone who is maybe a level one help desk technician who is going to be there just to help field fields requests from staff, but you know, doesn't have the ability to completely change somebody's account. They only have the ability to help reset a password. So you can read through the documentation inside Google Workspace to learn more about those individual roles and what is actually accessible there. You also have the ability to create a custom role. And inside a custom role, you can define exactly what you want someone to be able to do or not do. And you can effectively make up a combination of different roles and share that with somebody in particular. If you like this content, please hit subscribe and hit the bell notification so you can be notified when we go live or drop new content on the channel. Now, if you'd like to connect with us, hit us up on social media or join our free community group. All the links to that are right below this video. If you'd like to learn more about Google Workspace and the technology ecosystem, you can join our free Genius Academy by transferring your billing across to itGenius, or you can join a Workspace Basics Bootcamp. Now, if you're a business owner and you're interested in an audit on your technology stack or your Workspace account, or you're looking to do a project in the tech world, well, you can take advantage of our free consultation. And if you need help right now, then consider joining Concierge or taking up a quick fix with our team for professional support for your tech stack.